Hi everyone, and welcome back to case 19 of the brain tumor border view series. Today we're looking at a 67-year-old woman with diplopia or double vision. Here we have some images from a CT through the orbits. We've got double vision, so we're thinking about orbital abnormalities. Take a look at the orbits pretty well. All right, here's an MRI through kind of the same level. This is a T2 through the orbits. This is a T1. This is a T1 post contrast here. Here we see now a couple of post contrast images. We have an axial and a coronal, both through the lesion. Your clue here is to take a look and see if these look different at all and to think about why they might look different. Your question for case 19 is, what's the most likely diagnosis here? There's not a broad differential for this. You can usually narrow it down to one thing. And then question two is, what is the pathophysiology of this lesion? Is it a neoplasm? Is it vascular? Is it granulomatous disease? Or is it autoimmune? So this is a case of an orbital venous vascular malformation. These were previously referred to as hemangiomas, but this term is kind of falling out of favor because they're not neoplasms. These are well-defined encapsulated vascular lesions, so there are abnormal veins within the orbit. They can be symptomatic, as in this case, so the patient was having diplopia. They can increase in size as well, although it's somewhat rare. Now, in imaging, what you tend to have is you have T1 hypointense masses. They're very bright on T2. They have heterogeneous enhancement, and on post-contrast, they tend to progressively fill from outside to inside over the course of the study as the study delays, and I'll show you that as we go through. So here in our CT, we have a mass in the right orbital apex here. It's kind of up near the top of the orbit there. And so we've got a soft tissue mass there. So you want to do an MRI to characterize it a little bit better there. On T2, it's pretty hyperintense here. It's like very close to the vitreous in the eye or the CSF. Now on your T1 pre-contrast, it's pretty isointense to gray matter there. But on your post-contrast, it starts to enhance a little bit, and you're having some enhancement around the periphery of the lesion, but not completely. It's a little bit heterogeneous there. Now, here's where you have your real clue, or what really helps you make the slam dunk of this diagnosis. Now, this is the same axial image again, showing a little bit of peripheral enhancement along the posterior portion, but your coronal images, which are obtained later, so they're obtained after these, show almost complete filling of this lesion. So in the 3 or 5 minutes between these two series, the lesion has continued to fill in. This is kind of the characteristic finding of these venous vascular malformations or orbital hemangiomas. So when you see that, you can kind of say with a slam dunk that it's an orbital venous malformation. Now the pathophysiology, we talked about this, is these are vascular lesions. They're not neoplastic, and that's why the term hemangioma has kind of fallen out of favor. Granulomatous disease in the eye, you might think about sarcoid, autoimmune disease of the eye that can look similar to this, is your idiopathic orbital inflammation or IgG4 related orbital inflammatory disease. Thanks to everyone for tuning in to this case 19. We have one more case to go. We'll have it in a couple of days. Good luck to all of you who are studying for the exam, and be sure to like the channel and subscribe so you can get the notification about the final video that's going to come out. Thanks.